We got us a Lenovo ThinkPad P15 Gen 2. This is basically a workhorse laptop. If you are at a big company and you tell your boss to buy you a laptop to get real work done, heavy workloads, this is what they buy you. The box doesn't have tape on it because, I don't know, it came directly from Lenovo. That means it's probably from a lab. Somebody made sure it turned on and everything, but we're gonna open it up. This is not what you call a thin and light laptop. It is a thick and heavy laptop. 6.2 pounds, 15.6 inch, 16.9 panel. Boy, I should have broken out. We have some older ThinkPads here. It feels like it's about as big as those. It doesn't have a lock latch. Some of the older ThinkPad customers, you remember they used to have the thing to lock it shut? Oh, so now a couple things I want to point out. Very ThinkPad. You get your joystick, whatever they want to call it. I love this because you can, if you're standing up at a laptop, at a desk, at a bench, what I find is great. This is easier to use than this. It's really hard to use a trackpad sometimes if you're standing over it. I like stand over it. 10 key. People love 10 keys, right? But the correct 10 key. A lot of laptops with 10 keys from Asia have more of a phone where the zero is truncated, it's just a single button. This is more like somebody who would use accounting. If you're actually a 10 key user like me, this is what you get. 1.8 millimeters of travel, famous ThinkPad laptop keyboard. These keyboards are just lovely. Of course, not exactly no bezel look, 16.9. Let's see what's inside. I really don't know what the specs of this particular model are, so we're gonna crank it up and find out. But the P15 Gen 2 does pack, of course, the latest in hardware. We'll get to that in 1 second. I wanna see which screen option we got. So there's actually two 1080p, let's see, is it touch? Not touch, so really all work here, no touch. So there's really two options at 1080p. There's in this laptop, you have a 4K HDR 500 panel that's OLED. You have an HDR 400 that's 600 nits. And then you have two 1080p's. One is just a 300 nits, pretty plain. It's probably the base level. Then you have one step over that is Dolby Vision anti-glare, brighter, 500 nits. Let's see how bright this is. Too bright? Yeah, this is probably the 500 nit panel, it looks like. Inside this laptop, Core i9-11950H, that is Intel's newest 11th gen Tiger Lake H. Of course, it's an i9, there's a Xeon option, but this particular i9 has all the special vPro stuff. See the special vPro sticker? That means you get all the manageability that you get in a company, so your IT departments love these because they can manage them remotely. Those are premium features. They only push out to corporate-focused CPUs. The 11950 does do a turbo of up to 5 gigahertz. It is an 8-core CPU built on 10-nanometer super FinFET, as they call it. Sounds consumer, but a more commercial version of it. On the GPU side, this has a Quadro, see if I can get this right, Quadro RTX A5000. I know a lot of people probably are not used to what that is. That is basically the Quadro version of the GeForce RTX 3080. Same amount of cores, Tensor cores and all that stuff. Look, this is thick. And I know some people are like, what? I like thin in my workhorse laptops. Thick means more cooling, more battery, more performance. Oh, let's look at the port since we're here. What do we got? What do we got here? Type A, SD card. No smart card reader in here. Lock port, if you want to chain this down to a desk. Gigabit Ethernet. Another Type A. We actually had two.
Isn't that the battery?
Oh, you're right. I didn't see that for a second. You're right. This is the Lenovo charger. Which is always a little confused me because it looks like a USB port. As you can see, it's not. Lenovo's actually had this for a lot of years. It's lower profile than a round one. And the nice thing is most companies have about 1 billion of these things. So you can get these power bricks from their bin. This is a 230-watt model. Yep, 230 watts. Two Thunderbolt 4s, because it's Tiger Lake. A USB-C, and on this side, a full-size HDMI. Another USB-A. I don't know what this is. This probably is, maybe in a certain model, that's for a SIM card, possibly. Headset port. Oh, let's look. This is nice. This is like old school, right? You don't really see this that often. It is unfortunate companies have gone away from including ports. There we go. Oh, nice. Okay. So this gives you easy access. Lenovo has done this for a while. I guess it's probably to protect the memory. I don't know. It's not really for thermals. Maybe add a little bit of insulation or protection. Not really sure. So you're going to get two DDR4. And then, of course, storage. Let's try to get this without messing it up. Two M.2s. Ah, open. So this laptop already has a single M.2 Gen 4, 1 terabyte. And then if you want to add more, right here, easy to get to. Of course, you have the thermal pad. Keep it cool. You have this little bit of protective layer here. But look at this. It's in a door. This is so old school, but I love it because you don't have to pull the whole bottom of the stupid laptop off to get to. It's easy to service if I can get this door back. But this is the way it used to be in laptops. You can do this, of course, because this laptop is thicker. Oh, wait a minute. This might be a laptop that will come with Windows 11, because that does not look like a Windows 10 sticker to me. This particular laptop, though, does not have Windows 11. So, and most corporate customers will re-image their own version of Windows on there anyway. So 6 pounds. This particular laptop, 32 gigs, not ECC. ECC, you need the Xeon version, but you get the Quadro. Quadro, of course, for people who don't know, is basically the version of GeForce with the special drivers that they send to Autodesk and other content creation, any other professional workstation application makers. They take the drivers and make sure that you get what you get on the hardware that you're running it on, and you pay a buttload more than you would for GeForce. I know people say there's no performance difference, but I've actually been recently seeing data shown to me showing there's a huge difference going from a GeForce to a Quadro in certain applications. Say if you happen to be a defense contractor and you're making a new fighter jet, the application you're using will be faster because the drivers support it. That is mostly an artificial a decision by the makers, but if you're basically doing it for a living and you're making a $65 million plane, it doesn't matter anyway. So we're going to run a couple quick tests. I just want to remind you, this is not a review. We're doing a quick preview, just a couple CPU tests. I will do maybe a little bit on the Quadro, but we're not really outfitted to be running CAD software that you're going to build the F-35 on. But we're gonna run a couple things just to give you an idea, so come right back. Hey, so we're back. Just finished running a few benchmarks. Not everything I wanted to run, but we're gonna kick this off with Cinebench R20. Of course, it's a 3D modeling application, which you might actually do on a laptop like this. This is a Core i9-11950H. Performances for this, it's okay. Doesn't knock it out of the ballpark. There are faster laptops. Frankly, their old laptops are also bigger, generally 17.3-inch screens. But as you can see, this ThinkPad's, it's not bad. Although the i7 in a bigger laptop can outperform it. There's also a Lenovo performance tuning application I was not able to download and run on this. You might be able to goose a little bit more out of that Tiger Lake H part. But when you're looking at single-threaded performance, again, in Cinebench R20, it's actually pretty good. We're looking at performance running right there with an i9-11980HK, and that is a really hot CPU for lightly threaded tasks, single-threaded tasks, and you can see, again, bam, right there, almost as fast as the top end i9. We did also run V-Ray. This is basically doing 3D rendering on the you can do it on the CPU, but the cool kids today, they do it all on the GPU. So we actually ran it on the CPU using a CPU compute. It's actually called a CUDA version, although it runs on Radeon, which makes no sense. So I think it's really just a GPU version of V-Ray. And there's also one that runs using the hardware ray tracing components in the RTX cards. Performance of the ThinkPad, P15, not bad. Doesn't blow away those 3080s at 150 watt, 130 watt, or 165 watts. This, by the way, this A5000, Quadro RTX A5000, is 110 watt TGPs. So performance is pretty good. But you're probably not going to touch some of those really hot, big, fat laptops. Of course, this is not exactly a thin laptop. So you're going, well, Gordon, why do I want a Quadro RTX A5000 then? Because a 3080 GeForce looks like it's actually faster, or as fast in a lot of circumstances. I was trying to download SpecViewPerf, an industry standard workstation benchmark. I'm still downloading it. I've been downloading it for an hour and a half. So I don't really have the numbers to give you right now. So I'm actually going to show you some numbers from a competing laptop vendor. Yes, sorry, Lenovo. This is a results from Asus, but it does give you an idea of what you're going to get out of the Quadro A5000 in this laptop. This is performance of the Quadro series, RTX A3000, A4000, A5000. You can see on the right-hand side in the beige. Those are the Quadro parts, the RTX parts. These, of course, are in a different laptop, but you can expect very similar performance deltas between conventional GeForce and Quadro. And you can see that Quadro pretty much kicks the crap out of GeForce, and a lot of that is that special magic. You send the drivers off to Siemens and Katia and Creo, all these things where, you know, this is real industry stuff, and you get special magic out of them. A lot of that is somewhat artificial, because I don't doubt that a GeForce could be as fast, but it's not going to be as fast, because essentially if you're paying to ride in a Quadro RTX, you're going to get more performance. And in fact, look at that Siemens score. It's insane. GeForce just sucks there. And a Quadro RTX A5000 is like 19 times faster than a GeForce RTX 3080. Of course, you would argue, well, that's because they don't let that other card go as fast. And I would agree. But when you're getting paid a lot of money to do work on a laptop like this, it's going to be worth paying for that real workstation level graphics card. So that's it for the benchmarks for now. I do want to show you this really special treat. This is a ThinkPad T430. It's been sitting around, kicking around in our lab forever. It's about 10 years old, I think, maybe 9 years. It's an i7, original i7, Arendelle, I think. This is actually it's a smaller screen, I think, but it's really funny to me, because it's almost like Lenovo really knows there's that retro, people who buy ThinkPads want a ThinkPad. This keyboard is awesome.
The nub has been rough.
You can still buy replacements for them. These things are built like tanks. I know people don't understand why, but ThinkPads are built like tanks. I love them. The keyboards are lovely. And if you're into a ThinkPad, you're probably into like an old, you know, round Volvo. That's the kind of thing you're going for. This is all work, no play here. It's just amazing to me that it's so similar. You've got the access door for the memory. You've got access door for the memory on this baby. And it's probably almost about the same thickness. This one, of course, is a little bit wider because it has a bigger screen. So pretty nice.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
And people who want ThinkPad, that's what they want. They, in fact, Lenovo, this has been a feature for a while. ThinkPad, the little eye lights up. That's just a waste of power, but people want that in their ThinkPad. This tells you, I'm doing serious work. I could be working in the Pentagon with one of these. They're not going to give you some sleek aluminum thing. You're going to get something like one of these in the Pentagon. So I do want to talk about the price. I don't know the exact price of this unit looking at other P15 Gen 2s that Lenovo has on its website. It's going to be stiff. I found this same laptop with 128 gigs of memory. This thing has four DDR4 slots in here, so you can run up to 128 gigs of memory. So 128 gig 4K version with the A5000 and 11950H is about $5,000. That's like Apple pricing. So of course you're getting 128 gigs of memory, but it's not cheap. But again, this is a laptop designed for somebody who's going to sit in the Pentagon, or design something that's going to be used at the Pentagon. And it comes with a price tag attached to it. So we are going to try to get a full review of this. We don't normally do full reviews of workstation laptops like this, but I'll try to crank some benchmarks out of SpecView Perf once it's finished downloading. But come back to PCWorld.com for the full review.